Hello, I'm Willem Witteveen. I come from the Netherlands, where I teach at Tilburg University. And I've come to the International University here in San Servalo to teach two courses, one on justice and one course on rhetoric, on the art of persuasion. And I'm not alone in doing this. I will be here for about a month, and then three of my colleagues will be following me, three ladies also from Tilburg, and they will pick up the threads about justice and about rhetoric. So first of all, this is going to be a highly varied course. And it's also in the content full of variation. Take the subject of justice. The course is called Approaching Justice because we feel that justice, so many people have been writing about this. It started with Plato in classical Greece. It went on to John Rawls in the 20th century in America. And all through this time, there has been no consensus about justice. People keep disagreeing. Why is that? I believe it is because of injustice. There is so much injustice in the world, and everybody can see it and feel it and have their thoughts about it. And this puts pressure on all the theories. No theory is completely adequate. So injustice will also be part of this course. In my part, I will be starting out with Plato and his ideas of the ideal city in which everybody could find their ideal place. And I will move on to a novel by the Italian writer Italo Calvino, who imagined Venice, and Venice as a place of both justice and injustice. Well, so much for the first course on justice. The second course, Imagining Rhetoric, is in a way related to the course on justice. Why rhetoric? Rhetoric is the art of persuasion. It's about how people communicate with each other and get what they want. And why imagining rhetoric? Well, that is because there is simply so much rhetoric surrounding us and we are engaging in it all the time. There is the rhetoric of politicians, of salespersons, of priests, of soccer trainers, of us ourselves. So that it's hard to see where these ideas about what works in communication and what doesn't work, where it comes from. And it comes from olden times, it comes from classical Greece and Republican Rome. It starts with people like Plato again, and Cicero and Quintilian. And in this course, we are going to take you all the way from the classical past to modern times in a media democracy that we are living in now. So that's our plan. I will be the first speaker. I will be followed by a person from law, a person from literature, and a person from media studies. So that's what it's going to be. Thank you.